first of all, Dr. Jodry, what exactly is your title and your department?
I am the co-chair of the Department of Pathology here at Chester County Hospital, and I am also the director of the clinical lab. So basically I run the clinical side of pathology. So the clinical side includes blood bank, hematology, microbiology, the phlebotomists, and the LIS system. So I'm the director of all of that.
Okay. How did you get into pathology specifically?
So I went to University of Pennsylvania for medical school, and then I stayed on for residency. But in medical school, they really focus on specialties. And I wasn't quite sure what I wanted to do. And then I had the opportunity to go to a conference where all these attendings were talking, and they were given an unknown case, so they had to solve it. And at some points, it got kind of heated. They were kind of arguing back and forth as to what they thought the answer was. At the end of this conference, a resident stands up and then tells the whole audience what the answer was. And I thought, okay, well, who's that? You know, and a couple people said, well, that's the chief resident of pathology. So these guys are arguing back and forth, and you know, nobody really knows what the answer is. And then a pathology resident stands up, and everyone's like, yeah, they have the final answer. And I'm like, okay, that's what I want to do. So I started looking into pathology and then realized it was really something I wanted to do. So I really like the idea that pathologists have the final answer.
So as the director of pathology, to get where you are today, did you face any challenges as a woman specifically to be in the position you are now?
I think in some ways medicine is still a man's world. I think I've had to maybe prove myself a little bit more than I think I should have had to. But outside of that, even just looking at, you know, starting a family, I felt like I had to plan more in terms of actually carrying the baby and being pregnant during work. So, and for the laboratory, that's definitely something you have to think about because we're around formalin. For me, I think the challenges were, you know, having to balance my career and my social life to make sure that the balance was there so I could do both successfully.
With, you know, more women being prominent in medicine and in the science field, would you have any advice to the younger generation to get to a position such as yourself, or just staying in the science field, like the interest, how to inspire that?
My advice to anyone looking at these careers is to really know who you are in terms of what your personality aspects are. Are you somebody who does well with a lot of pressures, a lot of challenges? I mean, just getting a career in medicine as a female is a lot. But really having some kind of plan to attack what you want to accomplish, but knowing your limitations. And I mean, you really have to do some self-reflection with that. Really follow your inner voice, because that's probably going to lead you to where you want to go in the right direction more than anyone telling you how to do it.
Would you say that Chester County Hospital and Penn are a good place to work for women in the science field?
Absolutely. I've had so many opportunities here, as well as flexibility in my schedule. I just think there's been so many positive things that have occurred, even through the programming that they have here, how they structure the workday. It's just really something that you can work with in your schedule, social as well as career-wise, and get real job satisfaction from it.